So let's look more closely at what is called cache-to-cache transfers, which is what happens when core 1 has some block B in a modified state and another core puts a read request on the bus so that it wants to basically bring the block in its own cache. At this point, C1 has to react because C1 is the one that has to provide the data. If we have the block in the M state, that means that the only up-to-date copy in the system is our copy. Even the memory doesn't have an up-to-date copy. So if the data is going to be sent to C2, it had better be our data. But how? And we have briefly touched on this when we were discussing the MSI protocol. There are really two solutions. The first solution is abort and retry. The idea here is that C1 somehow cancels C2's request. And for that, we need some sort of an abort bus signal that when a request is placed on the bus, another core can assert the abort signal that tells the requesting core to kind of back off and try again later. Now that C2's request has been aborted, C1 can do a normal write back to memory. At this point, the memory has the up-to-date data, and when C2 retries its read request, it will get the data from memory. The problem with this approach is that really, from the time C2 makes the request, if this data was normally coming from memory, we would have a memory latency. So if this is just a read miss, we would have a memory latency. But if it is a read miss where another core has the data, we really have to have two memory latencies before C2 can get the data. One for the write back to memory to happen on C1, and then for us to actually get the data from memory. So the read miss from C1 has a latency that is twice the memory latency plus some. So this is why this approach is not ideal. The second solution is called intervention. In this case, C1 sees the read request is being made, and it tells the memory somehow that C1 will supply the data instead of the memory. So normally the memory would respond to a read miss request. Now C1 kind of tells memory that I will do that. And for that, we need an intervention bus signal through which C1, by asserting the intervention signal, signals to the memory not to respond. So the memory now doesn't respond with the data, but C1 does. And now the memory must pick up the data that C1 is responding with in order to put it in the appropriate memory block. The reason the memory has to pick up the data is that once C1 responds with the data, both C1 and C2 will have the block in the shared state, so both of them will think that the block is not dirty. And that means that if the memory doesn't get the data now, it will never get the fresh data. So by picking up the data, the memory ensures that it gets the data that will not be written back anymore. So the disadvantage of this approach is that it needs more complex hardware. Now a cache needs to be able to kind of insert its data into what would normally be the memory sending data, and also the memory has to have enough intelligence to pick up the data when a core is responding to an intervention request, instead of just picking up the data when there is a write-back request. In modern processors, we nowadays mostly use a variant of an intervention approach, and the reason is that, yes, the hardware is slightly more complex, but fancier snooping protocols actually eliminate the problem of memory picking up the data, and the complexity to respond with the data is not too large. In contrast here, the performance suffers, so pretty much between having a fancier protocol and having enough transistors from Moore's law to actually add this capability to caches, we pretty much can do this and not have to suffer in performance like this.